Elon Musk to launch insane telescope 100 times better than JWST. James Webb, step aside. Elon Musk has just signed a lucrative contract with NASA that could see SpaceX earn up to $255 million for the launch and delivery of the eagerly anticipated Grace Roman telescope. We have just finished waxing poetic about the first batch of James Webb photos, and yet here we are, reporting that a second, more powerful telescope is well on its way. I now understand your thoughts. Could this be the telescope that ousts the James Webb telescope even before it has spent a full year in orbit? Or, in the wise words of Neil deGrasse Tyson, will it be made for other exploratory purposes? Let's look. The Grace Roman telescope is set to launch atop the Falcon Heavy sometime in October 2026. On July 19th, SpaceX won the NLS-2 or NASA Launch Services 2 contract, which means that SpaceX would begin an indefinite arrangement with NASA to carry as many payloads and projects to space. According to reports, the launch will occur at Cape Canaveral, Florida's Launch Complex 39A of the Kennedy Space Center. With three Falcon 9 core engines that are absolute monsters and up to 27 Merlin engines, the Falcon Heavy currently holds the title of the most powerful operational rocket in the world. When you combine these features with the fact that the Falcon Heavy has completed three successful test flights, it becomes clear why NASA chose SpaceX. The Grace Roman telescope, which supposedly weighs 4.63 tons and is built like a stallion, must also be kept in mind. Before we even get into the nitty-gritty and technical stuff, let's take a quick look at the history of the Grace Roman telescope. The Falcon Heavy could dare to carry this labor-intensive astronomical instrument pitted against the effects of gravity to its desired destination, which in this case will be the second lag spectrum point situated approximately 1.5 million kilometers away from Earth. When the project was first announced in 2010, it was known as the Wide Field Infrared Survey Telescope, WFIRST. However, after the death of renowned astronomer Nancy Grace Roman in 2018, NASA decided to rename the telescope in recognition of Nancy's outstanding contributions to the science and study of astronomy. Pay attention, because we're about to get technical. The Grace Roman telescope is intended to lead mankind further down the rabbit hole by focusing on the three essential foundations of the universe: dark energy, dark matter, and exoplanets. The primary mirror of the Roman Space Telescope will be 2.4 meters in diameter, roughly the same size as the primary mirror of the Hubble Space Telescope. However, in contrast to Hubble, the Roman Space Telescope will be equipped with two major instruments, the Wide Field Instrument and the Coronagraph. According to reports, the inclusion of this new Wide Field Instrument will be groundbreaking. As a result, over the telescope's lifespan, we may soon be measuring the light from over a billion galaxies. In addition to seeing so many galaxies, we may also find exoplanets within the Milky Way, possibly as many as 2,600 of them. You might be wondering how the Grace Roman telescope will find so many exoplanets. Well, the coronagraph, a handy secondary instrument, will perform high-contrast imaging and spectroscopy, allowing us to find dozens of exoplanets in our galaxy, especially planets that have a striking resemblance in geological and atmospheric makeup to planet Earth. Here is the science of how it operates. For any observatory located on Earth's surface or in a lower orbit, it is practically impossible to capture the light from an exoplanet because the light from an exoplanet is typically 100 million times fainter than that of its host star, which is the star that it revolves around, similar to our Sun. This is one of the reasons why the Grace Roman telescope will be deployed on board the Lagrange Point. Lagrange points are locations in space where heightened zones of attraction and repulsion are produced by the gravitational forces of a two-body system, such as the Sun and the Earth. These can be employed by spacecraft to lower the amount of fuel needed to stay in place. Can you imagine how much fuel NASA would have to burn just to maintain a telescope? We would also have to launch numerous fuel loads worth hundreds of millions of dollars every month just to keep the telescope in position, which doesn't seem reasonable to me. Lagrange points are regions in space where the gravitational pulls of the Sun and the Earth are equal, causing an object within a Lagrange point to remain in position. As previously mentioned, the Grace Roman Telescope will concentrate on three key areas of study: dark energy, dark matter, and exoplanets. The instrument will be the first in space capable of directly capturing mature gas giant exoplanet systems like Saturn and Jupiter using reflected starlight. Such discoveries could pave the way for NASA to discover planets similar to our own. We will finally be able to answer questions that have puzzled about dark energy, like Albert Einstein and Adam Riess, such as, is dark energy a cosmological constant using spectroscopy, thanks to the Grace Roman Telescope's ability to measure factors like the equation and time evolution of dark energy. As for the dark matter, the Grace Roman Telescope will study the weak gravitational lensing effects of this strange substance and how distant galaxies are warped in small clumps of dark matter using Roman's wide field instrument. The Grace Roman Telescope will also measure redshifts or displacements in galaxies across defined parameters. Measuring such distortions will enable us to precisely calculate the distances of galaxies that are thousands of light years away. Scientists will be able to count and record the normal and dark matter of galaxies that number in the hundreds of millions. These observations are essential for understanding how dark matter has affected the formation and development of galaxies and stars as a whole. If we can observe galaxy formation occurring very early in cosmic history, we can ascertain whether dark matter is made of heavy particles that clump together quickly. However, if these particles show much slower growth and clumping, this may indicate that large-scale structures in the universe are established over a long time period. And, as a result, dark matter consists of light, fast-moving particles with such powerful interactions. The Grace Roman Telescope will use the coronagraph's time series microlensing images to study the Milky Way stars and recreate the distribution of exoplanets, particularly those with Earth-like masses that may someday serve as our future habitats. Future missions to find signs of life on exoplanets with atmospheres similar to Earth will be led by the Grace Roman Telescope's coronagraphic instrument. The coronagraph system will also be able to image planets that have striking similarities to other planets in our solar system, allowing us to record the photometric characteristics of numerous Neptunes, numerous Jupiters, and numerous Earths for the first time in aerospace history. Spread all across our galaxy, the majority of the missions carried out by the Grace Roman Telescope will focus on general astrophysics, which will be carried out by using the Wide Field Instrument. This will allow the Grace Roman Telescope to primarily carry out wide-field imaging and spectroscopy for several studies. In fact, the Kepler mission had initially confirmed that such planets are the most widely distributed in our galaxy. From what we can see, the James Webb Space Telescope and the Grace Roman Telescope are not going to be directly competing. Instead, the two telescopes will work together to provide us with a clearer, more concise picture of the cosmos. When all is said and done, it's an exciting time to be alive, especially if you have a strong interest in astronomy. We could be preparing for some of the most spectacular images of our galaxy, let alone the universe and beyond. They may also give us a clearer path to nearby planets that have an atmosphere that is conducive to human habitation. Are you excited about the Grace Roman Telescope? If so, tell us what you think of its debut in 2026 and what questions you hope it will help us solve in the coming years in the comments area below. Until then, thank you for watching.